let's talk period hygiene products. Now, if you are a 90s Indian kid like me, you might remember those ads where a solemn looking lady wearing all black would walk towards the camera and say, "Mujhe kuch kehna hai, par main kaise kahun?" And she would take out a pad and a cloth and then she would pour blue ink on both of them to demonstrate the superior absorbency power of the pad. Now, as a young kid, most of my extracurricular curiosities went unanswered. We were supposed to do only two things, eat our food and study. So I used to think that these were diapers for grown-ups. And I'd always wonder why her pee was blue. I'm pretty sure this curiosity subconsciously drove me to do medicine and become a doctor. But jokes aside, I feel we've come a long way since then in having open discussions about periods, and thankfully the industries are coming up with various products keeping the comfort and needs of a woman in mind. Now, from a menstrual standpoint, I feel our country is broadly divided into two groups. Those who have minimum to nil access to even basic sanitary pads and have to use a cloth as a substitute, and those who are fortunate enough to have a few options to choose from. So in this video, I'm going to take you through some of the popular products that are available in the Indian market and also talk about some foundations who are doing excellent work in spreading awareness about menstrual hygiene and making some eco-friendly sanitary pads. Let's begin. The first group of products are the ones that are disposable and are worn externally. I'm talking about sanitary pads. These are worn externally and they absorb the menstrual fluid from the outside. You can stick them to the underwear and therefore the risk of stains are minimalized. Now there are various sizes and shapes of these pads. There are ultra thin ones, then there are super absorbent ones, maxi, supers, and even post delivery pads are available on the market. So it all depends on the nature of your flow, if you have a light flow or a heavy flow. Now, the biggest pro for these products are that they're easily available in the Indian market. In most places in India, you can find a sanitary pad. But the biggest con is there is a lot of cellulose, fragrance, and some questionable chemicals that are present in these pads that have been linked to certain diseases. Now, research is still not sufficient here, but there are some studies that show this connection. The second con is if you have a heavy period, these may cause rashes and might be uncomfortable to wear, you know, if you have a longer period like 5 days or 7 days. The third biggest con is they are not environment friendly, so you know, and also expensive. So you might run through a lot of these pads and they are not easily disposable and they are not good for our planet. Talking about pads, there are also other types of pads called panty liners. Now, the biggest difference between a regular pad and panty liners are that they are super thin. Their absorbency is very, very minimal. So the best time to use these are just before your periods when you're experiencing some sort of spotting or if you have a vaginal discharge. So these will make sure that your underwear is dry and clean. Also, you know, if you're traveling and you're not sure whether tissue papers are available in the bathroom, then panty liners could be an excellent choice during those times as well. The second category of products are the ones that can be reused and are placed inside the vagina. The commonest are menstrual cups and a tampon. Now, before I talk about these things in detail, I'd like to go through a short description of the female anatomy. Now, this is a cross-section of the female reproductive system. This is not the exact model because this one has a vaginal ring which can be used as a contraception, but I'd like to explain through this in the best way possible. So basically, women have three openings. The first opening is from where you pee. It is called the urethral opening. The second opening, which is in the middle, is the actual vaginal opening, which again leads to your uterus and the ovaries. And the third opening is from where you poop, called the anal opening. Now, as opposed to men who only have two, so the urine and the semen comes out of the urethral opening in men. And a second one is the anal opening. So, as opposed to them, we have three openings. It's very important that we are aware of our own anatomy if we were to use any of these internal menstrual products. Let's begin with the menstrual cup. Now, menstrual cups are a safe, reusable and environment friendly ways to collect your menstrual fluid which is placed inside the vagina. Now let me show how you can squeeze it in. You could either fold it this way or you could even fold it this way. And then you need to squat so that you know the vaginal opening is comfortable for you to feel. And once you squeeze the cup, you can just insert it in the vaginal opening, and due to suction created, once it's inside, it will automatically open up. And you can use the funnel of the cup to make sure that it is snugly fitted in there. The most important thing with a menstrual cup is to properly learn as to how to clean it, insert it and remove it. Now there are various sizes of cups available in the market. For example, there are smaller cups for teenage girls, women who have not delivered yet, and then there are post-birth cups as well. So based on your preference, you can choose one of these. Now let's answer some of the questions that are commonly raised about menstrual cups. The first being, can you pee and poop while wearing a menstrual cup? Now, as I showed you, there are three distinct openings that women have. So peeing is easily done with a menstrual cup. But in terms of passing stools, again, it's a personal preference, because you know, when we pass stools, we exert and we apply some pressure. So that might make the cup move a little inside or might even make it come out. So it's better to remove the cup, wash it nicely, finish your business and then reinsert it. Now, the second question that commonly people ask is, will this make my vagina loose? Now, I think there's a big cultural myth that vaginal tightness is necessary for having any kind of sexual pleasure. But it's all that, it's just a myth. Because see, vagina is not like an elastic band that, you know, it would kind of stretch out and then it would loosen up. A baby can come out of the vagina and it can still go back to its normalcy. So inserting a small menstrual cup, which is approximately 4 cm in diameter, is not going to stretch out or thin out your vagina. The third important question people ask is, can I sleep with the cup inside? Can I do physical activities like swimming, yoga with the cup? The answer is yes, yes and yes. In fact, this is the best tool to have a good night's sleep without having the fear of stains. The reason being, a menstrual cup can be placed inside the vagina for almost up to 12 hours. You can swim, you can do yoga, you can even do gymming with a menstrual cup inside. In fact, most women forget that they are on their periods when they are using menstrual cups. The next question is, can I have sex while wearing a menstrual cup? Penetrative sex? No, but there are various other ways with which you can pleasure yourself. But penetrative sex is not possible with a menstrual cup inside. Other common question is, can I use the cup if I'm a virgin? Now, this whole concept of virginity, I feel, is a cultural thing. Because see, hymen is a membrane, as a thin membrane which sits at the opening of the vagina. It is not like, you know, it is a shield which is there, because even that has opening. Otherwise, how would the menstrual fluid come out every month? So virginity basically means someone who's not had penetrative sex. So wearing a menstrual cup will not rob you of your virginity. On the contrary, basically living life can also break the hymen. Doing yoga, riding a bicycle or even dancing can break your hymen. The other question that a lot of people have is, can a menstrual cup get lost inside me? No, it can't, because uterus is there with the cervix and the vagina is outside. So think of it as a sock. If you put something in a sock, it won't get lost. So this might move a little, it might go up sometimes, you know, based on the kind of activity you're doing, but it's still there. So all that you need to do is take a deep breath, relax, squat and bear down, you know, just how you would bear down if you are defecating. Similarly, just bear down, and by gravity, the cup would automatically come down and you can easily squeeze it and take it out. So there's no way that a cup could get lost inside you. So don't worry. The last thing I would like to emphasize on about menstrual cups is that it's very important to know how to clean it. So, you know, if you've ordered a new menstrual cup, it's best to wash it well with soap and water and then put it in boiling water for at least 5 to 6 minutes so that it is completely sterilized. And this process needs to be repeated between each month. And every time after 12 hours or after 8 hours, whenever you're taking out the cup, make sure that you have access to clean water so that you can wash it nicely and then reinsert it. There is also a lot of debate going on whether menstrual cups can be used in conjunction with an intrauterine device like copper tea or something. A lot of women find both these products sustainable and convenient. But for other women, there have been incidences of IUD rejection after you starting to use a menstrual cup. The three things to keep in mind is, first, always check the strength of the IUD before inserting the cup. The second is, release the suction before pulling the cup out so that, you know, it doesn't cause a negative pressure and pulls the IUD along with it. And the third thing I would suggest is, if you are already wearing an IUD, it's best to go to a gynecologist and make sure that you don't have a low cervix and that it's easy and safe for you to use a menstrual cup. Let's move on to tampons. Now, tampons are similar to menstrual cups in the way that they absorb the menstrual fluid from the inside so that there's no moisture on the outside. These come in varying sizes and absorbency levels, so it might be difficult for a beginner to choose something out of these. But practice makes perfect. Also, as you know, use different brands and different types, you will figure out what works the best for you. Let me just demonstrate how to insert a tampon. It is similar to that of menstrual cup, albeit this is much easier. So, especially girls who are going to college and they need a certain amount of comfort, tampons are really good options. So, you just insert it in the vagina and part of the thread hangs out. So, you know, it makes it easier for you to remove it. The thing with tampons is, you know, if you are unsure, then it's best to have a panty liner as an added protection when you're using tampons. The biggest con of a tampon is something called toxic shock syndrome. Tampons are supposed to be changed every 4 to 8 hours depending on your flow. So if you are someone who has a bit of a light or medium flow, you can, you know, keep it for 6 to 8 hours. But if you are someone with a heavy flow, then it's advised to change every 4 hours. You know, tampons, especially the super absorbent ones, have a high incidence of toxic shock syndrome. What is toxic shock syndrome? It is basically when you have a tampon soaked with blood sitting inside the vagina, it is like a field for bacterial growth. So that kind of an infection is very dangerous. You might have symptoms of fever, body ache, rashes in your body, and also vomiting or diarrhea. So please be cautious. If you are a tampon user and you have any of these symptoms, please go to your nearest hospital immediately because it could even be life threatening. So that is always a negative with a tampon. Now you may ask, is the incidence of TSS common even with menstrual cup? Research shows that it isn't as common, but if you leave a fully filled cup for more than 12 hours, then there have been some cases of TSS with menstrual cup as well. The essence is you get to enjoy all the benefits and comforts of these internal sanitary products, but the key is to change them at regular intervals. The last category of products are the reusable ones, which are extremely eco-friendly. Now, there are two types of variants available under this category. One are period panties and the other ones are reusable pads. Now, let's just go through a brief idea about what these are. So period panties on Amazon at least have two variants, one that can be washed and the other ones are disposable ones like this. So these are essentially like a panty, but they have super absorbent bases so that all the menstrual blood is absorbed like that. Now the reusable ones have this thick absorbing material that can take care of the period, but they have to be washed after every use. The same thing goes with the reusable pads as well. They have these buttons, so they button behind your underwear and then you can use them. The biggest con of the reusable pad at least is that they shift a lot, so you know, you might have stains and you might have to use a panty liner as an extra protection or something. Period panties on the other hand might be a bit bulky for a lot of people and might make them feel uncomfortable. Again, you can't go swimming or for other activities like that, like those with these products. But they are extremely environment friendly. Some brands even make antimicrobial period panties. In fact, there are also period leggings available. The other con that I find with reusable period panties or reusable pads are that they need to be washed and drying may take up a long time. And let's say you're at work or you're in school, carrying dirty pads around till you reach home to wash them might also be quite cumbersome. To summarize, for beginners, I feel the least intimidating and the easiest to use are disposable sanitary pads. So when someone attains puberty, it is best to that they begin with the disposable ones till they are comfortable with their periods. Now coming to the use of menstrual cups and tampons, it depends on how comfortable you are with your anatomy. So you know, inserting it, removing it and cleaning it in the beginning might seem like a task, but as you get used to it, those are the best options to wear, especially when you have an outdoor activity planned or you lead a very hectic life where you know you have to be at work for longer hours, then menstrual cups are the safest options to have. The third thing is for disabled people, using cups or tampons might be difficult. So then again, sanitary pads are the best options for them as well. Now we all know about Mr. Arunachalam Murganandam, the person who went through great efforts in making sanitary pads available for women across rural India. In fact, his foundation teaches women on how to manufacture sanitary pads in their own villages and then sell them to the people nearby. In fact, there is a documentary based on this called Period End of Sentence that won the best Oscar in the documentary section this year. If you have time, please take a look. It's available on Netflix. which details the account of these women of, you know, how they were using cloth before and how they switched to sanitary pads thanks to the vision of one man. There are also other NGOs who are also working tirelessly toward making sanitary pads available to women across India. If you'd like to contribute in any way to these foundations, I shall attach a link to them down in the description box below. Just like no two women are alike, no two periods are alike. So your choice of your menstrual product usually depends on your needs and your comfort level. Personally, for me, I am really grateful to be born a woman any which ways. But I'm also grateful to be born in the time where there are two options available. One, menstrual cups, because that has made life the easiest for me. Most of the times, I don't even remember that I'm on my period. And the second is availability of these products on e-commerce websites like Amazon and Flipkart. Thank you for your time and attention. Be well.